Hi everyone, this is Angie from Don't Pay Retail Thrift, and I'm just going to finish up my home tour. I can't believe this is four videos long. And anyway, I hope you're still interested and still watching. Before I show you the kitschy, tacky, but I love it, rest of my den, I was just going to show this is in one corner where I have a nativity that I made like many, many years ago. I think it's like a 9-piece. I used to have an angel that hung up in above baby Jesus, but I dropped her and she broke a few years back and I need to replace it. And it also has a light that I need to replace. But that I just sit that in my den. It's a pretty big one. And it probably needs some touch-up work because I've had it for probably 20 years or so. But I still love it and bring it out every year. And I think I got the manger, or the, what do you call this? I forgot. Somewhere else. I forget where I got that, but I've had it for years. And it just sits in front of this. This is just a moose tree that has special meaning for my family that stays up all year. And we add a moose from everywhere we go. For example, that was from Walden, Colorado. There's just a few just different moose on there. This is a really pretty one. It's like copper with Christmas on the antlers. Park City, Utah. And then the leaves are just fall leaves that I made in ceramics like years ago. And I just added to it. But like I said, that just stays up all the time. And we just add a moose ornament when we find one. So we'll move to the kitschy stuff. So this shelving unit I did, I just did two shelves on it. It actually has five, but I only did two. I just brought out my carolers because I really love them. This pair right here, I just love them. I got them at an estate sale. And someone made them. I can't remember who. But I got them for fairly inexpensive and I just love them. I could never sell them. I thought they were gorgeous. And I just have some, that's just a book of some ephemera that I got. I just threw that box of bulbs up there to kind of hide the books because there's books on this shelf normally, but I don't really move them. I just kind of lay them down and just hide them with the stuff. There's another Christmas Carol book that I got that I love. It had some really pretty graphics. There's another one of my ceramic trees, a white one, but I do not have the bulbs in it, nor do I have the light. But I just set that on a little Christmas Carol book. This little set I thrifted at an estate sale. Excuse me. And I thought it was cute how they used the red thumbtacks to hold the feet down. And I just left it like that. I'll probably add some little cotton for snow, but I forgot to. This picture I thrifted, I just love that I put it here because it's just such a pretty scene. The red barn and the snow, it just a pretty Christmas scene. There's a few little candle angels. I just stuck one in that little glass to make her a little higher. And then this one, I just loved her. She's a tree topper, but I just stick her up here. And this caroler I got at a recent, well, I say recent, like a month or so ago, I believe, a yard sale where the lady had made a bunch of stuff. And she's just really cute, made out of paper. And I'm probably going to, I think I'm going to attempt to try to make a couple to go with her. But I loved her. The lady did a great job. And then this shelf here is just sort of a Santa Claus shelf. There's one of my, let's see if I can get better lighting here. Lighting's not that great. One of my Santa Clauses back there. He's kind of in rough shape, but I still love him. And then there's a little tree, bottle brush tree. This little reindeer right here. I got it at an estate sale, and it's kind of like the blue Santa and Mrs. Claus that I made that I showed you guys in in either part one or part two. It's a music box. It's kind of the same thing, but it also doesn't have the music box in it. But it was just so cute. I loved it. Look at the little butterfly on its tail. I think I paid $2 for that at an estate sale. I just put another box of ornaments here that I didn't really put on the tree. A couple small boxes just to add some color. And this little Santa wall paper. I just stuck because it just hides the books. Two more little ceramic trees that I don't have lit up. I don't have the bulbs in. This was just kind of like a plastic, and it's like styrofoam behind it. Little Santa on a sleigh. I got that somewhere for really nothing. This is another one of my little felted Santas. This book was, I bought that last year. It's not vintage, but it just has that cute vintage look. I couldn't leave it. It's like a book, but it's also for storage. This little Santa with the boot, I recently thrifted somewhere. Just love it. It's a ceramic piece. This little guy, I remember I showed him in a haul video. I never did find out any information on him. He had one red boot, one red shoe. The other one wasn't painted. He had a Japan sticker, if I remember right. And, yeah, I just never could find any information on him. So I just decided to keep him because he kind of looks like a Campbell's kid. But I could not find anything on him. This is just a little salt and pepper set that I got. It's Mr. and Miss Claus dancing. And I kind of like when Miss Claus has a little green on her. This one is just one that I also found at an estate sale. It's just a little painted set. And they were just really cute. And they're sitting on this little, one of those, like, 70s picture boxes. My sister gave me that a few years back. And she put family pictures in it. And, I loved it because I thought that was such a sweet idea. That's me and my mom and some of my sisters. And she put that because it was, I guess, the blank one. But that's, I don't show myself, but that's me and my mom. That's quite old, probably at least 10 years old. But I sit it so you can see the Santa, and I just sit those guys on top. But I love that. That's, if you ever want to do something really sweet for someone, that's a fabulous idea to do that. And that's pretty much all I have on that shelf. And I have another shelving unit right beside it, but I didn't decorate it. So I'll show you my fireplace. And I don't know if I can get this to focus, but this is kind of my tacky, kitschy fireplace. But this is where most of my trees went this year. You see the first one here, and they're not really going to focus, I guess, because I have them on. But this one here is a really pretty one. I just couldn't find the base for it this year. I love this one because it's a pretty green color, and it's flocked, or it has a snow on each tip and the really pretty bulbs. So I just sat it here, but couldn't find the base. This was one I made years ago, and I just sat it up on a tin. This was one of my favorites because of the base. It's really pretty. I've showed it before. It has a lot of color and decoration. It's like toys all around the bottom. This was the one that had the birds with the glitter acrylic paint instead of glaze. That's just a box I bought from the store to store stuff in. This is the big one. This is the same size as the pearlized white one that I showed you upstairs. But it has a lot of damage to this first ring. And I don't normally put it all the rings on it. But since I put it low, I thought I would try it. And it did all right this year. This one, that's just a little Santa that my sister gave her. I think he's skiing or walking, or what do you call it when you're walking on snowshoes. This one I love because it's all red bulbs. This one was one of my absolute favorites. It has the really vintage bulbs in it that have the glitter on them, but it does not get as bright as the rest of them. And then this one is really pretty. It's kind of a really Christmas green, Kelly green almost, with the pretty orangey red base. And then I just hung this little guy. He's just something I found thrifting. And I found three of these really cute, the plastic vintage wreaths. I hung one here and one here. And I have another one that I actually didn't hang up. But like I said, when I rinsed those things off and got the dust off, they were just so pretty. But it's just a plastic 50s, 60s stuff. These were two vintage stockings that I found that I just loved. I love this one. That's just a piece of a snowman that I just stuck up there because I had it. That is a, I forget where I got the Santa blow mold. And I decided I no longer put my blow molds outside because They fade here in Colorado. I have some Halloween ones, and I will not put them out anymore because they've just faded too much. This was a vintage ceramic Santa that I found, and someone did a great job on painting him. He's the kind with the little sack right here. I usually put candy canes in it. These bells I absolutely love. I found, like, I thrifted, I think, a set of three. They're really pretty bright red when they're not lit up, and I love this kind of tacky plastic stuff here. And they blink. The middle one, I think, has stopped blinking since I hung it all up. But I sold the other two sets for, like, pretty decent money, and I decided to keep one for myself. This big Santa I framed. Took me a long time to find a frame big enough because it's really big. But all my pictures that are normally on my fireplace, I just leave up and I just stick stuff in front of it. I don't take it down. And this big antler my husband found in the woods, it's an elk antler. So I stuck this little ephemera deer up here. And this little fabric cardinal I thrifted somewhere. It's just kind of a hodgepodge. This tree I found in Goodwill for 99 cents. It was in perfect condition. This is my base that I made years ago that I sat it on. And this, I just love this little red angel. I thrifted her somewhere, and I just love her. I was going to put her on this tree, but she has this kind of bottom, and you can't. She's made in Japan, but you can't put her on the tree, like stick her on the tree. So I just stuck her on the mantle. Here's another blow mold Santa. I think I got him actually off of eBay. And I don't really do a lot of fancy garland. I just hang my big lights with the color because I just love the color. That's all I do. This tree here, I got it free from an estate sale. There were two Christmas trees, and the guy said just take them for free. And they are vintage trees. I can't remember the name on the box, but they are that plastic too, like the wreaths that I was showing you. So you can't put a lot of lights on them because they were so brittle. A lot of them were trying to break. But I put it together, and then I just stuck some red lights up in the middle. And I used to love to do just the red beads and the red and white lights. I didn't put white lights because I didn't really have any. I just stuck the red lights. But it looks really pretty. I put these Noel lights on here, but I don't like the fact that they're blinking. I told you guys I had a lot of light issues this year. But I don't usually put a tree in here, but I did this year because I had all these vintage ornaments. And I thought, well, I got the tree for free, so let me put it up and see what it looks like. And it actually turned out cute. But let me show you my favorite thing I thrifted. I'm holding this remote control. I thrifted a remote control light so I can turn it off with the remote. And that's so cool. So now you can kind of see it. It doesn't have a lot on it. There's a lot of space in between each branch you might not can see. But I just put some of my cutest little vintage ornaments that I thrifted over the past year or two. They're mostly Santas, and mostly red, except her. I have two of those little girls. I have two of these little Santa and Mrs. Claus riding a tandem bike. This little guy is like he's like one of the Seven Dwarfs elves maybe, but a little couple cardinals, another cute little felted angel. I do have a star there, but you can't really see it. Actually, I have one on each side. And then this Santa was just a little wooden. I think he's supposed to, like, stick down in a plant, but I just stuck him at the top. I have a lot of these little Santas. This cute one. That's a really cute ball, a Christmas ball with Mr. and Miss Claus kissing. Another little blue angel. Another one of those little sequin ones. And that's another one of the little wooden ones, which I noticed she has both of her wings. There's my other little blue one. I love this little green bell with the little girl inside with the little tacky, kitschy flower on top. I stuck a couple angels in the tree. That little one. This was just all the ornaments that really just I thrifted. There's the other Santa and Miss Claus on a bike. It's so weird that I found two of those. I love that little candle. That's pretty much most of them. But, yeah, I don't know if I'll keep it. But I thought it was really pretty. And, yeah, it made it pretty in here with the red lights. But, I wish I could remember the name of the tree, but the post in the middle is like brown, kind of covered with sort of brown plastic, and it just, it's just different than any tree I've ever seen. And it's probably not showing up very well in this video, though. But the other tree, the guy actually gave me two trees for free that day. The other one is a little bit different than this, but when I got it home, it did not have the pole that all the limbs go in. And they're sort of like triangular shaped limbs. So I'm probably going to just take those limbs and maybe tie them together and kind of hang them like you hang the greenery and maybe put some ornaments on them and just craft with it. But that's pretty much that. I also have this Santa up here. He's like my blue one that I showed you. I painted this guy. He's way bigger and you're probably not seeing him too well. But I painted him years ago. I did one for my mom, and I also did Mrs. Claus for my mom. And then I did the same set for my mom's boss. So when I got to mine, I did mine last. I didn't want Mrs. Claus because I just wanted the red, white, and black. And the Mrs. Claus that goes with this guy has a lot of... She's sitting in a chair, and she's knitting. So there's a lot of other colors you have to bring in. I just wanted the red and black and white. So I never did her for me, but now I'm kind of wishing I had of. And the last thing that I put in here, well, I'll show you. I did actually put a Mrs. Claus in here. Let me show you her. I have this old thrifted pillow. It's just one of those kind that you sew it together and fill it full of fiberfill. And this is another vintage pillow that I've had for years. But this was the Mrs. Claus that I got. This is like an 80s Claus. I got her at it when I went to an auction house, and it was almost all Christmas, and I bought a ton of Christmas. But she's like one of those 80s brooms where you would have do like a broom and make it, and it was an 80s thing. But somebody made her. She's holding her little basket of greenery, and she's not showing up too well, probably. I couldn't really sell her because if I tried to sell her and ship her, she would just fall apart. But I thought, you know what? She's cute. She deserves to be hanging somewhere. So I hung her in here. And I actually kind of like her. She's kind of grown on me. I didn't like her at first. And this is that little candle that I showed you guys I thrifted. It came like in its original packaging, which was really cool. It's just a flicker candle with a glass globe, and it's got the little greenery around the bottom. I love it. It is really pretty. And it's pretty like anywhere you put it.